The subject of this session is of relevance not only in context of Central and Northern Europe, but also for the steppe zone of the Eastern Europe in the early Middle Age, and in particular in the epoch of Khazar Kaganat, between the 7th and 9th centuries. For decades, Russian archaeologists have continued their discussions and disputes, unable to agree on the terminology to be used in reference to a number of archaeological sites which are surrounded by stone walls, ditches and embankments, as well as containing the ruins of buildings made of stone blocks and bricks on the site, and such material as the tiling and plastering of the elaborated masonry recovered in the cultural layer. Are these marks of early urbanization, and would it be correct to refer to them as towns, fortresses, castles, or just fortified settlements? What is the role, then, of the size of the settlements in hectares, the presence of artisan workshops, as well as of other settlements found outside the walls which are not fortified? Of interest in this aspect is the Fleurov's book, The Towns and Castles of Khazar Kaganat, Archaeological Reality. The author gives a critical survey of every archaeological site dated to the Khazar Kaganat epoch, which were recovered in the forest steppe zone along the rivers Tikhaya Sosna, Oskol, and Seversky Donets. In the steppe area of the Lower Don, in the semi-desert steppe of the Volga Delta, and in the valleys of the Northern Caucasus, on the sea coast of Crimea. His main conclusion is, all these archaeological sites cannot be designated as towns, despite their large size, the surrounding stone walls, the remains of buildings, and the settlements situated outside the walls. Unfortunately, he failed to suggest a term to refer to the sites in question. However, the archaeological literature in Russia has been using the long-standing term of gorodishe for fortified settlement, which corresponds more or less to the German Burgwall. Gennady Afanasyev classifies such settlements into two types, including, first, the gorodishe fortified with the help of scarps, ditches, and earth embankments as the most basic devices built for security purposes. And second, the gorodishe with the geometrically shaped fortresses built of raw baked bricks or elaborated stone blocks. The first type of the settlement, widespread in the southeastern Europe, was used for protection of the clan groups or territorial communities. The second type is associated with the late antique early Byzantine traditions. They were built with the help of Byzantine architects and builders. Such gorodishe settlements were designed to protect the state of the Khazar Kaganat. According to Afanasyev database, the area of the forest steppe and steppe between the Volga and Don comprises 48 gorodishe or urban developments. Using these methods, he was able to identify 6 fortified agglomerations. two of these were located in the rivers Tikhaya Sosna and Oskol in forest steppe zone, which were surrounded by cemeteries where the burials were made in catacombs. In terms of the anthropological type, they are associated with Alans, who migrated from the North Caucasus. Some scholars believe that they formed a confederation with Khazars, while according to others, they were integrated into the Kaganat. The third and fourth of the agglomerations located on the river Severny Donets this is also a forest steppe zone. In the settlements, we were surrounded by cemeteries with cremations and pit burials. The population associated with them is believed to be related at least to three ethnic groups: Slavic, Turkic, Iranian, and Finno-Ugric backgrounds. Of particular interest in the context of our presentation is the fact that the fifth and sixth agglomeration are located in the low course of the Don River in the steppe. The cemeteries surrounding them are characterized by the Kurgan mound type of burial rite. In terms of their anthropological type, they show a significant Mongoloid component. Notably, the scholars agree on the Khazar origin of the steppe archaeological site. Of the 36 gorodishe in the forest steppe zone, only three are identified as type 2. For example, those with the geometrical shaped stone forts. Of the 12 gorodishe in the steppe zone, cited by Afanasyev, six belong to this type, which is a clear sign that the center of Khazar Kaganat was in the steppe. Let us have a look at the maps of some of these gorodishe, and we will see that this is a combination with burial kurgan burial burials. Let us which always most elevated part of settlement. Of them have this fortified part and the lower part of the gorodishe of the settlement and the necropole, the kurgans around the settlement. This is classical archaeological site Sarkel, which was excavated for first or second world war. The construction of the gorodishe in the the steppe zones of Khazar Kaganat made in Byzantine tradition has been dated to the period between 830 and 840s. The chronology was established in accordance with the radiocarbon data of the goods from Alexeyevskaya and Mayatsky Gorodishe and the coin 813 from the treasure recovered from Pravoberezhnoye Tsimlyanskoye Gorodishe. This is old excavations of the black white from Sarkel. Pravoberezhnoye is 6 kilometers from Sarkel 1. And so the big high position stone constructions. In 2010 and 2015, another two settlements comprising stone constructions, Bashanta 1 and Bashanta 2, were recovered in the south of Rio Dona in the steppe. Steppe had land as a part of the steppe agglomeration. So I modernize it. This is Bashanta 1 and Bashanta 2, a little bit south from agglomeration. The examination of Bashanta 1 and Bashanta 2 gorodishe has been at the initial stage. Hence, the following information is largely of a preliminary character. Bashanta 1 is located on the bank of small lake. When a dam was being built on the site, large elaborate building blocks of shell stones, fragments of pottery and tile, calyptera and pyramidae and other building material were recovered on the 500 long area from the bottom of the lake with a powerful excavator. The blue ones, this is, blue punct, they are all the stone blocks were on the surface now. Like this, with this is the statistic which size have Approximately 7 ton of the stone light of the surface of the site. According to the two radiocarbon data, so how I get to the two data carried out in Leibniz Laboratory of the Kiel University, Bashanta 1 seems to be earliest of the urban developments in the East European steppe dating to the time of Chasar Kaganat. The Bashanta gorodishe contains the ruins of construction made of 5 clam shell stone blocks. The tile fragments from Bashanta 1 are parallel to those found in Hersones of the Crimea. In 2015, a trial trench 250 square meters was made on the western part of the site. But I'd like to back, but that, I don't know. Okay. We can make back the picture. The northeastern western part of the site on the cave. Back. Yes, this is trapezoidal elevation with a lot of stones, and this is our trench. The arrangement of large shell stones cut into blocks with traces of arts working indicates the outline of building 14th by 16th in size. The northeastern corner of the trench revealed the foundation stone with clan tamga. A fragment of the building wall made a single block of 7 stone slabs were recovered along southern edge of the trench. The stone slabs had fragments of plastering. The southeastern corner of the trench contained a stone slab with the edge elaborated as a semi-circle of an outer corner. Numerous finds include elaborated building stones of a small size, pottery tile, pieces of plastering and animal bones. The ceramic material comprises amphora of the Pontic Coast type and the pottery of the Southern Maitskaya culture. This is radiocarbon dates. The archaeological survey made 8 kilometers to the east of the Bashanta 1 resulted in discovering another settlement located on the river Igarlik. Its fortified part has a trapezoidal shape with the basis base to the main part of gorodishe site. This is the trapezoidal shape, and the main part of the settlement is here. The eastern side of the gorodishe was bordered by the half arch of mud, which seems to have been fluotype because the now bulbrush has started to grow along the whole of its length. The western part forms a gradual slope to the river. The trial trench resulted in showing a fragment of building. The stone wall of fort made a large elaborated shell stones put in single line of three rows. The numerous finds collected on the whole territory of the gorodishe comprise fragments of pottery, tile, and the cut stones. The material recovered from other trenches is similar to that of Bashanta 1, which allows to conclude that the new site is a part of the same agglomeration and hence its designation as Bashanta 2. Thank you very much.